गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। सो टुडे बिफोर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइज 5.2, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव सम आइडिया अबाउट द पैरेलल लाइंस एंड ट्रांसवर्सल। सो ऑल ऑफ यू, आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पैरेलल लाइंस। सी स्टूडेंट्स हियर, सो पैरेलल लाइंस आर दोज व्हेन टू लाइंस आर सेड टू बी पैरेलल लाइंस व्हेन they do not intersect each other. In another words, here in the example I took four lines here, okay, but actually in the definition what I wrote here two lines, okay. You may also take two lines here. See here I drawn two lines here. This one is AB and this one is a CD, okay. So when I increase the length of both these lines in the both the direction like this, and this one also like this, see here what I did here, I increased the length of both these lines in both the sides, in this direction I also increased the length, but they not intersect in front of or behind here, students. Okay, so such type of lines we call them as a parallel lines. Okay, so parallel lines, what parallel lines are those when they do not intersect each other after increasing in a both the direction. So this is regarding the parallel lines, students. Okay, see this one example here I am going to write here. See both these are, whether these are parallel lines? No, because after increasing in one direction they intersect here. So both these lines they are not a parallel lines, because after increasing in one direction both these lines they intersected here, okay. So therefore both these lines they are not a parallel lines. So parallel lines means what? After increasing the length of the lines in both the direction, if they not meet, so those lines we call them as a parallel lines, okay. And see the next one, students, transversal. So what is the meaning of transversal? When a line intersects two lines at distinct points or at separate points, it is called a transversal. See here, AB and CD, both these are the parallel lines, students, okay. AB and CD, both these are parallel lines, and this line is intersected by MN line. So this MN line we call it as a transversal, okay. This line we call it as a transversal. Understood, students? So transversal means when a line intersects two lines at distinct point. Distinct points means at separate points. So in this point and in this point, this transversal intersect both these parallel lines, okay. And this line we call it as a transversal line, students. Understood all of this one? And in this figure MN, it is a transversal here. And one more point is that, students, these parallel lines we represent by this symbol, okay. So this is symbol of parallel, students, okay. And next we are going to study about angles made by transversal. See here, when a transversal intersect two parallel lines, what type of angles are formed? See here, downside, students, all of you here, angles made by transversal. So what are the, which angles are made by that transversal? See, students, here first one, interior angles, okay. So before going to explain all these, see here, when a transversal intersect a parallel lines, here 8 angles are formed, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 like that, students, okay. And here first one, here we are going to study about the interior angles. So what is the meaning of interior angles and how to find out those angles in the given figure? See, students, here interior angles means inside the parallel lines. See here this AB and CD, both these are parallel lines, okay. So inside the parallel lines, which angles are there? 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6, all these angles we call them as a interior angles. Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6, all these are the interior angles. So interior angles means inside the parallel lines. Inside the parallel lines, all these angles we call them as a interior angle, students. Understood? And exterior means outside the parallel lines. See here, this ABCD, outside the parallel line means 1, 2, 7, 8. 1, 1, 2, 7, 8. So all these four angles, these are the exterior angle, students, because all these four angles, they are the outside the outside the parallel lines. Okay, so these angles we call them as a exterior angle, students. And next one is that corresponding angles. So corresponding angles, what are those here? Regarding corresponding angles, students, here we have to make a pair here. So what are those? All of you see here, 1 and 5. See here, this 1 and 5, this is a set of a corresponding angle. Another one, 2 and 6. 2 and 6, it is another pair of corresponding angles. Similarly, 3 and 7 and 4 and 8, both these, all these are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles means one outside and one inside, and both the angles should be at one side of this transversal. Okay, see here, this 1 and 5, both these angles, they are one side of this transversal, students, here. So it means this 1 and 5, this is a first pair of corresponding angles. Similarly, 2 and 6, both these are a second set, sorry, 2 and 6, both these are a second pair of corresponding angles. Similarly, 3 and 7, this is a third pair of corresponding angles. And next, 4 and 8, it is another pair of corresponding angles, friends. So this is regarding the corresponding angles. See the next type of angles, students, all of you here, alternate interior angles. So far all of you know about the interior angles and exterior angles, friends. Okay, so that for both these interior and exterior angle, we have to add one more term, that is alternate interior angles and alternate exterior angles. So what is the meaning of this? All of you see, students, here. Okay, see the figure here, this is 3 and 6. Okay, see, this is 3 and 6. So this 3 and 6, both these are, this is a set, this is a first pair of alternate interior angles. So this 3, 4, 5, 6, all these are the interior angles, students, as I told before. And here, alternate means opposite angles. So this 3 and 6, both these are alternate interior angles. And similarly, 4 and 5, so it is another pair of alternate interior angles, friends. Okay, understood all of this one? And regarding the alternate exterior angles, see here, this is 2 and 7. Okay, students, this is 2 and 7, so this is a first pair of alternate exterior angles. And similarly, this 1 and 8, so this the opposite of this one angle is which one? It is a 8. Okay, 1 and 8, and here 2 and 7, both these pair of set, these are the alternate exterior angle, students. I hope all of you understood this one. See the next one, that is a 6th one, students. All of you see here, what is that? Interior on the same side of a transversal. See here, interior, so this is the transversal line. Interior means inside. Okay, exterior means outside, interior means inside, exterior means outside. See here, interior on the same side of transversal. Here, what are those? This 3 and 5. This 3 and 5. This is a first pair of interior on the same side of transversal. And this 4 and 6. This is another pair of interior on the same side of transversal in this figure, students. Okay. So, I hope all of you understood all these types of angles. And after understanding all these, some important points you have to keep in mind, in your mind, students. So what are those important points all of you see here, students? Because to solve the problems, all these are very, to solve the problems of exercise 5.2, so all these points are very, very important for us. So what are those points all of you see here, important points? First one, each pair of corresponding angles are equal. So as I told before, what are those corresponding angles here? 1 5, okay, this is 1 5, 2 6, okay, and next 3 7, and next 4 8. So all these are corresponding angles, all these are the corresponding angles, and all these angles, they are each they are equal. It means for one angle, angle 5 is equal here. For angle 1, angle 5 is equal. Similarly, for angle 2, angle 6, is equal. And for angle 3, angle 7 is equal. And for angle 4, angle 8 is equal, students. Okay. And second point, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Similarly here, 3 and 6. See here in this figure, 3 and 6 and 4 and 5. Each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. See, this is a very, very important point, students, here. Only alternate interior angles are equal here. That is, interior angles means what? This 3 opposite angles. The opposite of 3 is which one? It is a 6. And similarly, opposite of this angle 4, which one? It is a 5. So this 3 and 6 here equal, and similarly 4 angle 4 and angle 5 are equal here, as I wrote outside upside here. Okay, students. So this is the second point. And what about the third point all of you see here? Each pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. So regarding supplementary, what is the meaning of supplementary? I explained in the previous exercise. Supplementary means sum of two angles should be how much? It is a 180 degree. See here, each pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal. I mean this 3 and 5. Okay. This 3 and 5. Both these are the pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal. So sum of both these angles, how much it is? 180. It means angle 3 and angle 5. Angle 3 and angle 5. Both these are the which type of angles? Both these, as I explained before here. So these are nothing but interior on the same side of transversal. Okay, students. So sum of both these angles, how much it is? A supplementary. I mean it is a 180 degree. And similarly here, this 4 and 6, these are the interior angles on the same side of transversal. So sum of both these angles are also, it is a 180 degree. It means both these angles are the supplementary. So this is regarding the basic idea about the parallel lines and transversal and angles formed by transversal. So I hope all of you understood all these basic points, students. And tomorrow I am going to start the new exercise. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.